Hello, my name is Ramesh. I'm a senior product manager for Amazon DataZone.
Hello, my name is Navneet. I'm a principal specialist at AWS. Today, we will demonstrate how Amazon DataZone empowers data producers and consumers to discover and share data at scale across organizational boundaries, all while maintaining data governance and access controls using a healthcare use case. With Amazon DataZone, you don't have to choose between agility in getting to the data you need and data governance for accessing and sharing data across your enterprise. You can get both.
As we know, every enterprise is made up of multiple teams that own and use data across a variety of distributed data stores, across on-premises, multiple cloud providers, and SaaS providers like Salesforce. And to do their job, analysts, data scientists, and engineers need this scattered data that sits across these different data sources, owned by different teams, but do not have an easy way to access or even have visibility to the data. Amazon DataZone fills this gap. It provides a unified environment, a zone where everyone in your organization, from data producers to data consumers, can go to access, share, and consume data in a governed way. Let's jump into how it works.
I'm going to use a very typical scenario that we see across our customers in healthcare and life sciences. In this scenario, a data analyst is trying to find the right group of patients for a study by analyzing clinical data and past trials information. In our clinical data scenario, we have Julia, who is a data engineer in clinical department. Working alongside a team of engineers and experts, Julia manages raw patient information from different sources and often gets requests from various teams to get the right data for analysis. To share this data more easily and securely, she wants to catalog and publish it in Amazon DataZone. She is our data producer.
And Marina is a seasoned analyst. She is a clinical trial expert who wants to use this medical records and trials data to identify patients that fit specific criteria. She is our data consumer. Let's see how Amazon DataZone helps connect them.
Let's start with Julia and see how she publishes data into Amazon DataZone. She logs into the DataZone portal using her corporate credentials. She creates a project and environment which she can use to publish data. She knows the data sources that she wants to make available. So she curates and creates an automated ingestion job to connect to the clinical trial data. She provides a name and description for the job, and then selects databases and specifies the criteria for what specific table metadata she wants to pull into the catalog. She chooses automated metadata generation option, check to get machine learning generated business names for technical table and column names. She also sets how frequently she wants to sync the data from sources. Within a few minutes, the clinical data and the trials metadata, such as table names, schema, and other source metadata, will be available in Amazon DataZone in a draft mode. Julia will then have the option to enrich the metadata and provide rich context to make it easy for Marina and other data consumers to discover and understand the data. She can either accept automatically generated recommendation to auto-populate business-friendly names. She can also provide description, classified terms, and any other useful information for this particular data set. Once Julia has curated this particular data asset, she publishes it to make it available for data consumers in Amazon DataZone.
Now that data is published and available in the data catalog, Marina from the research team can use Amazon DataZone to easily locate this data. She simply logs into Amazon DataZone and uses the search panel to search for data. A list of relevant assets is written, and she learns more about the data and where it comes from. She can now filter the result based on variety of facets, such as glossary terms, data sources, and sort result based on relevance and time. Now, to perform the patient cohort analysis, Marina knows the data she is after. So she now subscribes to the data within the context of the newly created cohort analysis project. Once the subscription is approved, any of her project member can click on the Athena or Redshift link and be taken directly to the corresponding service console without the need for additional configuration or individual permissions. And finally, Marina and her team members are able to query data from multiple data sources in a secure environment. So as you can see, the entire data discovery and access lifecycle and usage is happening through DataZone. You get complete visibility and control over how the data is being shared, who is doing so, and who authorized it. Essentially, Amazon DataZone allows you to give your organization the freedom they always wanted with the confidence of the right governance around it.
Amazon DataZone public APIs will allow for easy integration across your choice of data and analytics solution, while still having the same level of visibility and governance across all the data you want to use for decision making. Thank you for watching this demo.